I am in New Haven, Connecticut, with my friend from India, Ayush. He's walking up to me. He's now a student for his master's degree in Sweden. And you have seen a video that I dedicated to him. And we are here with my wife.
Hello.
Ayush is over in the United States for a conference for a few days. We are now in one of the most famous libraries in the entire world. Shana, what is the name of this library?
It's one of the most famous, don't you remember?
It is. No, I don't remember the name.
Beinecke.
Beinecke?
Yes.
Okay.
Or Beinecke. Depends on how
Beinecke
you...
Beinecke or Beinecke, according to my wife. It is truly stunning what they have here. And the building is mind-boggling too. I will add some later, okay? Here you see the famous first edition of the Gutenberg Bible. There probably was only one edition, which is this copy, made in approximately 1455. It was before I was born. Hand printed by Gutenberg, who was the inventor of the printing press. So this is considered the first book in the history of mankind that was ever printed using a printing press, rather than that every word was written by hand. This was a revolution, probably the most important revolution, except for Darwin's evolution, probably the most important revolution of all kinds, of all times, namely that hundreds of copies, nowadays tens of thousands of copies, can be made with a printing press. Gutenberg, I believe, made 150 copies of this. If you want to know the exact number, use the web. But that's the first book what you're looking at made with a printing press in approximately 1455.
All right, go ahead, Ayush.
So we just came out of the library. You see, are you still? And there are two other people, and they recognized me. The person in the middle, whose name I do not know yet, but he will tell me, is now a student at MIT. And the woman on my right is his girlfriend, and she is from China. And so you see, no matter where I go in the world, I have friends.
Great.
Yeah.
It's our pleasure.
And Ayush was already a friend of mine, how many years ago?
5 years now.
5 years ago. Thank you very much for stopping me.
Thank you.
And enjoy New Haven.
Thank you.
By the way, today is special day for Yale.
Yeah.
You know, it's graduation day tomorrow, so that's why it's so crowded here.
Thank you.
Okay, so now you see here the area where I think tomorrow, right, is your official day.
Tomorrow is the official.
You see all these chairs? Just like we have at MIT. Outdoors, I hope for the best. MIT, we always have a tent as a fallback position. You probably have that too.
I believe we do, towards in that direction.
Oh yeah. Okay, in case you want to remember, Yale, which is a university in New Haven, 2019. We are now in the Yale Art Museum. Look. Three hoppers there on the wall. Three Edward Hoppers. My wife and Ayush. Agnes Agarwal. They're talking about art, no doubt. Edward Hopper. Edward Hopper. Edward Hopper. Oh, another one. Edward Hopper. This is not an Edward Hopper.
What?
This is not an Edward Hopper.
No, it's not.
Gorky. But in the Koning. Robert Motherwell. Giacometti, Pollock, Agnes Agarwal, quite a museum, right?
Yes, it is.
Shana? Is that a Twombly? Is that a Twombly?
I would guess. I haven't gone there yet.
But did you check that?
No. I'm working my way around.
Okay, okay. Your favorite painter? Léger.
One of my favorite painters.
One of your favorite. And here,
this is not
also a favorite of yours.
Hans Hofmann.
Hans Hofmann.
There are some really ugly.
Oh, look there. Ayush.
Yes.
Your favorite painter.
Oh, look, this is a Malevich. You know, you showed us the picture.
Remember that I said to you the painting that he showed me?
Yeah.
That I said it was Russian avant-garde?
Yeah.
Okay, look at this.
Yes. I recognize these.
So I will later make an estimate for you of the time that it was made.
Mm-hmm.
I will not do that now.
Okay.
And I will also make an estimate when this was made,
mm-hmm,
by Mondrian. And I will make an estimate when this one was made, which is probably about the same time that that one was made. Wow, they have three Mondrians. Okay, now if you may think that this is a Mondrian, then you're wrong. And if you think that that is a Mondrian, then you're also wrong. Even if you think that this is a Mondrian, it unquestionably influenced, but it's not a Mondrian. Wow, they have a Brancusi here. And that must be Jean Miró.
I think they have two Brancusis. Walter?
Yes, Shana?
I think there are two Brancusis.
I don't understand. That's a Brancusi.
And I said there's another one.
Oh, there's another one. This is Paul Delvaux, very typical. And that is Susan Schaufman walking away. Oh, this is a Dechirico. He's the godfather of surrealism. No day in a museum should end without a
Van Gogh.
Van Gogh. Which we pronounce as Van Gogh. But you have to be Dutch to say Van Gogh correctly.
That is really one of my favorites.
That is a Van Gogh. I made that probably in 1890. Could be 1889. Or 1883 even. 1888. And that's Gauguin.
It's really, every time I come, I will contemplate.
It's the walls and just everything.
He was in Arles. He lived in Arles when he made this painting.
There was that intentional twisting of perspective, like how everything is kind of a little bit twisted. It doesn't really kind of exactly
like his bedroom, you know, the bedroom.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. And also the chair.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
And look at the lights. The auras around the light.
And there's that.
Which he also uses in Starry Night.
Yeah, there's that visceral feeling of kind of really wanting to hold on to something.
So my guess is it was made in either 88 or 89, 1888 or 1889.
This is really a masterpiece. I really love this. But sometimes I feel like that there's something deeply unethical about it. Like, it tells about his troubled mind, his mental health, you know? It's not something that we should encourage. It's not a way of thinking that we should encourage.
Oh, that I think we should try to understand him.
I know, but then...
we don't have to become him. We can just understand what he went through. I mean, remember, people hated his work.
I know.
I mean, he wasn't appreciated.
He wasn't.
He knew something we didn't.
Hey, there's another Van Gogh there.
Oh, that is also a masterpiece. I love that. That is also.
Same period, 1888, 89.
I don't know if I would have guessed.
You lived in Arles.
This is
France.
He did an entire series of orchards. I think it was around the madhouse that he was
there. Yeah.
Well, Shana made a new friend in the museum.
We all did. Everybody makes friends in museums.
So you see here what Arius is wearing, a commercial for his university in Stockholm. KTH. Wetenskap och konst. For those of you who are Swedish, you know what it means. But if you're Dutch, you also know what it means. Because wetenschap in Dutch is wetenschap. And that means science. And kunst in Dutch is kunst, is art. So it is science and art. Wonderful that you're wearing that, Arius. Because those two are both magic.
They are.
Look what Arius is wearing.
Look at the back of it.
It's magic.
No, the back you like even better.
Physics and art are both magic. Can you turn around, Arius? Bits Pirani.
I knew he'd like that.
So is that an advertisement for your university in India?
Yes.
So Shana, why don't you turn around and show me what you have on your back?
I don't have anything on my back.
Very good. Ayush, I make a proposal.
Okay.
Take a video of me of only 3 or 5 seconds.
Okay, absolutely.
Because at least they know that I'm part of all this. And when you're done, you can push this red button.
Okay.
Here, then it stops.
Okay. Do you want a lemonade, Walter?
Just a second, let's first. See that red button?
Yes.
So when you push it, the video stops.
Yes. But do you want to say something?
No, I'm holding back. You finish this. End it. So just in case you forgot who I am, I'm here with Ayus Agrawal and with my wife Susan. And we are now in a restaurant in New Haven. And that's going to be the end of this video. Thank you, Arius, for visiting us again in the United States. And I hope we'll see you again.
Definitely.
At your graduation.